God wants our nation to have good government. He wants our nation to receive the blessings of our forefathers that fought and died so that this nation could be a free nation, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. In 1 Timothy 2:1, it says this, "First of all, then I urge that entreaties, prayers, petitions, thanksgivings be made on behalf of all men and for kings and all who are in authority." Why? In order that we may live a tranquil and quiet life in all godliness and dignity. Then it goes on and says, "And this is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Father, who desires that all men should be saved." God has a reason for good government. He wants us to live peaceably and righteously. He wants us to be able to pursue the dreams that He's placed in our hearts. But one of the reasons that God wants good government is He wishes that all men should be saved. He wants the gospel to be able to go forth into all nations. He wants the freedom that good government gives for the gospel to go forth in power. In Romans 10:13, it says, "Whosoever will call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." Well, then it goes on and says, "How can they call on Him whom they have not believed? And how can they believe on Him whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without a preacher?" See, God wants good government because He wants the gospel to go forth. And there's something that good government supplies. In the book, Shaping History Through Prayer and Fasting, Derek Prince talks about good government and how God uses good government to cause the gospel to go forth in power. He uses it to promote the gospel so that men and women can hear and be saved. Listen to what he says about good government. It says this, "On the one hand, good government maintains law and order. It keeps communications open. It preserves civil liberties. It protects freedom of speech and freedom to assemble. It is noteworthy that nearly all these points are specifically covered by the Constitution of the United States of America. In short, good government, without being involved in religious controversy, provides a climate in which the gospel can be preached effectively." Then Derek Prince goes on in this book and talks about what happens when we have bad government. It says, "On the other hand, bad government allows the breakdown of law and order, permits unsafe travel conditions and poor communications, and imposes unjust and arbitrary restrictions. In all these ways and in various degrees, bad government hinders the effective preaching of the truth. At its worst, bad government either restricts or totally suppresses the universal rights of all men to believe in God and to express their faith in public worship and proclamation. In one degree or another, we can see these conditions in countries under communist rule today." Father, in the name of Jesus, we're asking for good government, Lord. We're asking, Lord God, that you give us government so the gospel can go forth in power, so that men and women can hear how great you are and they can be saved, Lord God. We're asking in the name of Jesus, Lord, Father God, that you would set in men and women that fear and honor you, that will have the wisdom of heaven because they'll acknowledge you, Lord. Lord, that will do what is right and good in your sight because they fear you. And Lord, they love justice and righteousness, Lord God. Father, we're asking that you turn the hearts of the people of this nation, Lord God, to vote righteously, Lord. And God, that they would vote for men and women that honor you and fear you. God, we bind every hindering force in Jesus' name from all outside parties that would try to turn our nation, Lord God, to a certain direction, Father. We thank you, Father God, for your hand upon our nation. And God, we're asking for your mercy and your grace during these 2012 elections. In Jesus' name, amen. Now press share and let's get people praying for these 2012 elections. God bless you. Bye-bye.